Hi, this is Ken once again. Welcome to Prayer Line. Precious one, today is the day that the Lord has made. We'll rejoice and be glad in it. Today, the wrath of God is certainly visiting many of the churches because the Bible says that judgment will begin in the house of God. Today, we have a countless number of churches being shut down. They are being foreclosed because they are not able to meet their mortgage. All due to the fact that most of the churches now operating are not operating with the Spirit of God. It is human ideas, philosophies, human manipulation taking place in most of the church. The presence of God is really not there. And people are merchandising the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, making money out of the gospel. They will rather you give them your tithe and offering and leave anyhow. They don't care about how you live. All they care is that they will tell you that if you don't pay your tithe, if you don't pay your offering, you're not going to be blessed and things will not go well with you. So pay your tithe and offering. It doesn't matter how you live your life. It doesn't matter how what you are doing in secret places. All you need to do is to make sure that you bring in your tithe and offering. It has been prosperity gospel, which has now, you know, blinded so many people and have led many into deception. It has even infiltrated into the many of the African churches. Many of the African pastors are blinded by these prosperity gurus. And therefore now they pride themselves into buying jet planes at the expense of people living in poverty in Africa. In the Horn of Africa, right now in Uganda, in Somalia, people are dying out of starvation. These guys don't care. All they care is that we want to buy jet planes, we want to live large. It's all about prosperity. And they are not preaching the truth that Jesus Christ is coming very soon, any moment from now. Our Lord Jesus is coming. And these pastors and preachers and prophets and popes and archbishops are not preaching the truth. They are deceiving the masses with just the things of this world. They are preaching the horizontal gospel, the gospel of prosperity, your best life now, health world. And we have people like Juanita Bynum, Clifford Dollar, T.G. Jakes, Joyce Meyer, John Osteen, and all these bunch of deceptive preachers who are just selling the gospel to them, making them feel good, feeding them ear-tickling news and gospel, and not preparing them for the soon return of our Lord Jesus Christ. Precious one, many of the churches are now being shut down. Almost 217 churches are being shut down, including the Crystal Cathedral. It has been shut down. They spent millions into just the architecture and the decoration, but today they've lost the property to the Catholics because the presence of God is no more in many of the churches. It is all about activities. It is all about philosophies. It is all about psychology. It is all about sociology, ways of manipulating people, twisting their hands and selling the gospel to them. Today, everything you need to buy your blessing, you need to buy your protection, you need to buy the anointing oil, you need to buy the anointing or handkerchief. It is all deceiving the masses. And unfortunately, many so-called Christians who do not want to serve Jesus Christ in truth and in spirit and not concentrating themselves from the things of this world and are not living a holy life are blinded by these false preachers, and they have made idols of these false preachers. Today they will spend thousands of dollars at the expense of their poverty, struggling to go to their seminary, which is cemetery, just to learn nothing and come back still depressed, and they are sick. They are chasing after vanity, chasing after the air, and yesterday they are never contented, never satisfied. And these prosperity, paganistic, adulterous preachers are now giving them ear-tickling sermons. However, they are not dealing with them with their sin issue. They are okay if you come in a lesbian or a gay, you come in masturbating, homosexual, whatever is your sin is, just come in, stay as you are, and they are deceiving many. Today, Jesus Christ is not in many of the churches. The true church are worshiping Jesus in truth and in spirit and taking him seriously and are waiting for the soon return of our Lord Jesus Christ. Heaven will be filled with surprises. Only few will make it. The Bible says that many will desire to go to heaven, but only few will be able to go through the narrow path and get there. And I tell you the truth, most of the archbishops and bishops, you are idolizing them like an American idol. They are blind, leading you into the ditch. So repent, turn to Jesus, and wait for his soon return. Just watch some of these videos and you see how far you have been bewitched and be deceived.
On America's churches, in record numbers as lenders increasingly lose patience with religious facilities that have defaulted on their mortgages. Since 2010, 270 churches have been sold after defaulting on their loans. In some cases, even if you were current on payments.
Name brand Impian.
Other than Dick.
Because I'm going to tell you something. You writing with a big today. You in a low grade.
You writing with a big today.
You in a low grade.
You writing with a big today. You in a low grade.
And the reason why I say that, because BIC is for the common person. Everybody has it. BIC is for the common person. Everybody has it.
BIC is for the common person. Everybody has it.
If you use BIC pens, then you're a common person, which means of ordinary qualities, without special rank or position kind of person. Shame on the leader for saying something so foolish while insulting everyone who used the brand.
And the first association that I want you to have with this class is there's something special about me.
We need to want you to know that there is something special about her.
And I'm not the norm and I'm not the average. You know, they just print BICs out, you know, they just, you know, that's it. And so you gotta upgrade your signature because your name means more than that. Your name means more than that. You gotta have signature to your name. Your writing instrument determines where you're headed.
So if someone uses a big brand pen, then their life is going nowhere.
It says you understand the value of what you write down. Okay. Okay, did that help somebody? Did it help somebody? You know, Pastor Phil, that's a serious thing right there. Seriously, I paid up to like $5,000 for ink pen. I paid up to like $5,000 for ink pen. And how to use it for certain things.
$5,000 for a pen that she only used for certain things. Just the other day, she was begging people to send her $200,000 for her building project. Why didn't she sell her $5,000 pen and put that money towards her project? Because she, like many preachers, would rather you pay for their projects while they live the good life, writing million-dollar deals with $5,000 pens. Now listen to the purpose for having a $5,000 pen.
It's like, okay, when I'm signing my multi-million-dollar deals, I'm gonna write with this pen right here.
He had a nice car. He had a pretty little girl playing with a big pretty dog, and I kept reading, and I saw that you can buy those dogs, and I wanted, and they said a dog will watch the house and take care of your family. I said, I got the money, I'm getting my wife one of these dogs, and somebody's got to go in there on that dog, I'm going to eat them. That dog understands three languages. I ain't talking about no mutt. When the doorbell ring at the front, 23 yellow, still be with me. Drive on the seat. I just bought my boy a new Lexus.
What?
Lexus. My little boy, he got a convertible. He's 17 years old, he got a new convertible.
What?
They all know about you. He said, I increase you more and more. You and your church.
Come on.